kaungunahan ngayong araw ang programang ito ng Malapangulong Bongbong Marcos, yung ceremonial signing of Memorandum of Understanding and launching of the Media and Information Literacy Campaign of the President Communication of Office, mga kabay, kung saan isa sa pag-uusapan yung mga nagpo-post na mga fake news sa social media. So, nandito ang iba-ibang companies ng mga social media like Facebook, Instagram, Messenger, Twitter, at YouTube, Viber. No, lahat ng mga social media is nandito, mga kabayan, no, na gamit sa atin dito sa Pilipinas para makiisa sa programa ng national government, mga kabayan. At siyempre, yung mga media department at media companies nandito rin, mga kabayan. At nandito rin ang mga kasama ng mga vloggers na patuloy na nagsasabi ng totoo at pawang katotohanan lamang, mga kabayan, yung mga binablog din nila. No, kagaya nila Sir Alvin, Juan Historiador, Vincent Tabigi, yan, Papa Bean, RTV, Romeo Talk TV, tsaka yan, Palarista TV, and Geovlogs, Kakaraki, sino ba? Yan, si RG Angelis, Ma'am Sin, at sino pa yung mga nandito na kilala natin? Nandito rin sila, Mami Ping, ano, magkakaibang grupo pero magkakasama tayo, Kuya Sin, at Jocelyn TV 13, Ching No Boundaries, Joy TV, Ate Anne Sipon, at Black and Fish, Papa Roger. Yun yung mga ano, social media influencer na nandito. Tsaka yung iba pa, no, actually marami dito hindi ko rin kilala. Pero sila lahat ay gumagamit ng social media account, mga kabayan, at inaabangan na yung mahal na Pangulong Bongbong Marcos magsasalita-salita dahil papasok na rin po siya, kaya nakaantabay ng lahat.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the Republic of the Philippines, His Excellency Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. Good afternoon. We are.
Ay, tabunan pa rin.
Benjamin Abalos, Chairman Prospero Oliver III, Undersecretary Eduardo Punay, Assistant Secretary Dexter Galiban, ladies and gentlemen, esteemed partners, members of the media, and advocates for better informed society. Magandang hapon po sa ating lahat. Today, we stand together for an empowered and vigilant society. Today, we celebrate the launch of a unified effort by the Marcos administration and the most influential members of the digital media industry. We are not merely embarking on a mission. We are empowering a collective endeavor to exemplify the power of a whole-of-nation approach and indeed, a whole of society commitment. Sa panahon po natin ngayon, ay napakadali na ang pagkuha ng impormasyon gamit ang mga bagong teknolohiya, online news, at social media. Ngunit kasabay nito ang mabilis din pagkalat ng maling impormasyon. False narratives and fake news have the power to mislead, divide, and even cause harm or damage. Our responsibility then is clear, to arm our citizens with the tools to discern truth from falsehood. Sa tulong ng Department of Education, Commission on Higher Education, Department of Interior and Local Government, at Department of Social Welfare and Development, kami ay umaasa na magiging matagumpay ang layunan natin na labanan ang misinformation at fake news. Together, we are taking on this feat that is not just crucial, but imperative for the well-being of our digital world. Our reach extends further with our partners, Meta, Google, TikTok, and X, reputable giants in the digital scheme. Their support strengthens our causes, underlining the gravity of our message. Our formidable alliance is committed to ensuring that truth and accuracy prevail in a society where every voice contributes to the chorus of truth. Sisimulan po natin ang ating mga kabataan dahil sila ang pinaka-exposed sa digital landscape at sa mga panganib nito. Sa pamamagitan ng media and information literacy campaign, bibigyan natin sila ng mga kasangkapan upang kritikal na mapagsuri at makapag-validate ng mga pinagbulan ng mga impormasyon at malaman ang pinagkaiba na mapanlinlang na kasunganingan mula sa katotohanan. With our education sector equally dedicated to this cause, our campaign intends to introduce these efforts to the school curriculum to ensure that every student in the country is equipped to fight fake news. Ngunit ang ating misyon ay hindi lamang sa loob ng paaralan. Dadalhin natin ito sa ating mga komunidad. Magkikipag-usap tayo sa ating mga local leaders, civil servants, at ordinaryong mamamayan. We will enable them to navigate the digital world with discernment and responsibility. In doing so, we hope to raise a society of synthesizers, those who are able to use the right information at the right time for the right purpose to make the right choices. As we march forward, we envision a future that protects the fundamental rights of everyone. We therefore commit to tailoring today's efforts to address the needs of those who consistently face the exploits of fake news, women, children, the elderly, and those without easy access to technology. Ladies and gentlemen, what we are launching today is a unifying force that calls upon every sector of our society to join hands and ensure the triumph of truth. It is a demonstration of what we can achieve when government, private partners, and citizens collaborate for the betterment of the country. In closing, let us remember that today we are not just witnesses to history, we are architects of change and champions of a more enlightened and empowered citizenry. Marami pong salamat at mabuhay po tayong lahat.
Thank you, Secretary Garofalo. At this point, may we request the President to lead the signing of the commitment wall together with the Department of Interior and Local Government Secretary Abalos, Presidential Communications Office Secretary Garofalo, Department of Social Welfare and Development Representative Under Secretary Bunay, Commission on Higher Education Chairman De Vera III, and may we also invite DepEd Representative Assistant Secretary Galvan and the representatives from our social media platforms to join and proceed on stage. We have Google Philippines, Meta Philippines and Thailand, and TikTok Philippines and Malaysia. request the President to kindly grant us a photo opportunity together with the Cabinet Secretaries and Representatives from social media platforms. Thank you, Mr. President, and congratulations. We shall now proceed to the ceremonial signing. May we request the President to kindly witness the ceremonial signing between the Department of Interior and Local Government, Secretary Avalos, Presidential Communications Office, Secretary Garofil, Department of Social Welfare and Development, Undersecretary Punay, Commission on Higher Education Chairman De Vera III and DepEd Assistant Secretary Galvan.
Karunungan pala.
The Media and Information Literacy Campaign intends to combat misinformation and disinformation, especially in the digital landscape. In order to achieve such a feat, the Presidential Communications Office established a partnership with the DepEd, CHED, DILG, and DSWD to target the youth in schools and in their communities. The top social media platforms are also here with us today to collaborate on measures to effectively equip the youth to become discerning consumers of information. Now another photo op showing the newly signed Memorandum of Understanding. Thank you, Mr. President, Secretary Avalos, Secretary Garofil, Undersecretary Punay, Chairman De Vera, and Assistant Secretary Galvan. And now may we call on Interior and Local Government Secretary Benjamin D. Avalos Jr. to introduce our guest of honor.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the Republic of the Philippines, His Excellency Ferdinand Romualdez Marcos Jr.
Secretary of the Interior and Local Government, Secretary Benhard Avalos, please take this seat. The Presidential Communications Office Secretary, Cheloy Garofil, and our Chairman, Chairman Popoy Rivera, the Department of Social Welfare and Development Undersecretary,
ito yung ngayon nakita, hindi na nakabarong dahil nakikita kami pagka bagyo eh. At saka pag medyo, yeah, medyo disente tayo ngayon.
All my fellow workers in government, my partners in the private sector, all important private sectors, private sector partners, especially for this very, very important subject matter that we are trying to address today. Other distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon to you. I am, of course, very happy to join the guests from the government and the private sector to witness the signing of the Memorandum of Understanding between key government agencies and the launching of the Media and Information, or MIL, project. In this day and age, the world has grown very much smaller because of technological advancements that hasten our integration into a single, cohesive, digital society. The digital world is both borderless and also limitless, and everyone can now claim to be a netizen. With just a few clicks of a mouse or a few touches on mobile devices, and we have joined the rest of the world when it comes to cyberspace. Back in the day, there was a time, a long time ago, some of the kids don't even remember this time, that we had to actually go out and engage with actual people. actual human beings to again to engage in the exchange of information, the exchange of and to have a line of communication. But now we reach out to millions of people in the comfort of our homes, in our schools, in our workspaces, and through, of course, all the digital platforms that we have available to us today. News and information, which was, of course, delivered through the what we now call the traditional media, newspapers, radio, television. Now, the multitude of information is available to anyone, anywhere, anytime. But that is information, pure and raw, and unedited and uncurated and unexamined information. It is put out there. And that's why they say the internet is a great equalizer. Because the traditional media, for example, if you read an article that you're interested in, or that you would like to comment on, that you would like to respond to, you write a letter. And you say, dear editor, I am in full agreement with the op-ed, the column that was written by your columnist last Thursday about blah, blah, blah. And that is the only way that you can communicate. Now, it is purely interactive. While the guy's doing his blog, you can be telling him, nah, that's not true. This is completely different. We have a completely different experience. What you're saying might apply in your area, and it doesn't apply now. And this is why he or she is still in the middle of their blog, is still in the middle of their post. And so that is how quickly now that interaction, that's why it's, as I said, it is called the great equalizer. And because anyone can be part of the digital world. But therein comes also the problem. When you talk to, for example, political commentators and say you have been working for the New York Times for the last 35 years in the Middle East, or you have been working for Financial Times in Hong Kong for the last 35 years. And now we get our opinions not from that fellow who has been working in one place for 35 years, but we don't know where it's coming from anymore. We're not sure where it's coming from, because anyone can go on the internet and spread their opinion. And everyone is entitled, of course, to their own opinion, but everyone also has the prerogative of being wrong. So that is where the problem arises. Because there used to be a joke. We would say, it must be true, I read it in the paper. And people would say, don't believe everything that you read on the paper. We also hear the same thing now. It's on the internet, it must be true. And there, again, that we see, because we see that we are not sure. When we talk to that reporter, or the commentator, or the author, who has been working at a certain thing for his entire life, their entire lives, and now they have somebody who is a 14-year-old who's just having fun and doesn't really know much about what they're talking about, come on the internet and say, and this is regarded with equal credibility. Because it's very hard for us to know, because it's also new. It's very hard for us to know exactly. So you go back, you do a little research. You find out who is this person. One of the best examples of this happening was during the pandemic. The people would say, this is thing that you can do, but they think, be pro-vax, anti-vax, do you wear a mask, don't wear a mask, it's a political statement, that we were all confused. And there was very little that you could do to find out, except to find out who these people were. And that's a funny example. A friend of mine sent me, I said, you should read it during the lockdown. You should read this. This guy makes a lot of sense. There's this dad, medyo may pagka-outrageous yung kanyang mga advice. So binasa ko. And I said, well, the only best way to do this is by the, who is this guy? Baka naman Mayo Clinic. Diba? Baka naman nasa Stanford Center of Research. So pinay, I watched. I looked, and it was a pathologist. And I told my friend, I said, why are you listening to a pathologist? If they make a mistake, it doesn't matter. Their patients are already dead. So we should not be listening to these people. And that's what we are attempting to do here. What we are attempting to do here is specifically, as Secretary Chelo mentioned, we also direct our attention to young people because they are the most involved. They are the ones who consider being online, being working on the internet as part of their life. It's like breathing to young people. But we must give them the tools to be able to look and see what are these things that we are reading. Totoo ba ito? Should we really be doing something about it? Should I worry? Or should I just not worry? Because this is what people are telling me. And then it goes into every part of our lives. It becomes dangerous. It became dangerous during the pandemic because people were giving me some very outrageous advice, and this was hurting other people. But then it has now extended now into the, it has become such an important tool in the political realm. And we all hear about fake news. We all hear that the entire campaign, I've heard this in reference to somebody I know, that their entire campaign was based on fake news. Everything that they said on the internet was fake news. Well, maybe it's time that we give our kids, not only our kids, but our citizens, the tools to be able for them to tell what is important, what is not, what is relevant, where the sources of this information come from. We have all heard the phrase, know your source. So that is perhaps the first step that we can do for our people. As to say, know your source. Tignan nyo kung saan galing, kung ano yung kwento na yan. Baka nag-inuman lang yung mga yan, kasi kung ano-ano naisip, sinulat sa internet. Maniniwala naman tayo. Kailangan na yung bantayan natin. Yan. If you will notice, when we signed the poster on the Media and Information Literacy Campaign, what I wrote there is fight for the truth. And this is all that we are talking about, and this is as much as we are talking about. We cannot, what we are fighting for is the truth. Because what is the very first casualty of all of these sometimes sinister, sometimes just mistaken, misguided activities. The first victim, the first casualty is the truth. And we must allow everyone to be able to discern for themselves. We could help them, but people have to learn to be able to discern for themselves what is real and what is not, what is propaganda, what is fact, what is data, and what is speculation. These are all the things that we would like for people to learn. And it is something that we have to learn. This is all very new. My sons laugh at me when I say, do you know that there was a time when there were no telephones and there were no computers? And yeah, that's sure. They just cannot imagine that such a world existed. But younger generations here will remember that. And it has, but now this is the world that people face. It is not, I did not grow up with it. I grew up with it. I learned about computers and the digital world, cyberspace in school. But kids, three-year-old, I saw a three-year-old singing his toy to his control box. So what are you doing? Oh, I'm sinking it. Three-year-old kid. And that, but that's how involved we are. That's how embedded, how large a part all of this plays into our life. We used to call it the information technology. Well, let us recognize now there is good information and there's bad information. And it's up to us to make sure that we cannot stop it. I don't think that there's ever been any country, no matter how much they wanted to try and stop the internet, or to try and block, or to try and cancel websites. They do for a little while, but really, we always somehow find a way in. So we have to find a way to make sure that whatever the inputs our people are gathering, they have the capability, they have the ability to be able to discern between truth, speculation, propaganda, and outright lies. And that is the job that we are starting here today. And we need everyone to be involved. With the advent of AI, we can see that the tools that are available are becoming more and more powerful. And we're all very grateful when our machines do a little bit of dark thinking for us. But it's also rather disconcerting when we are confronted by pure AI. Hindi na tao yung kausap mo. Kung ano na lang pwedeng sabihin. And that's something that we have to learn how to deal with. And that is why what we are doing here today, starting this campaign, is very, very important. And that is why I thank you all for being involved in this. It is immediate, it is urgent. And although I think that if we put our minds to it, there is a way to allow our people to be able to discern from truth and everything else. Thank you and good afternoon.
Thank you, Mr. President. And that concludes our program. Thank you, Mr. President, for gracing the launch of the Media and Information Literacy Campaign today. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, His Excellency Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr.